on behalf of Acri Aviation Private Limited. It's an honor to welcome our chief guest, Jasmine Gaur, to enhance a beautiful topic of soft skill acquisition. Let's learn how to learn. We welcome you, ma'am. The session is over to you.
Thank you so much.
Welcome.
Hello everyone, a very good afternoon to all of you. I welcome you all to this session. My name is Jasmine Kaur and I am an independent training consultant and a freelance soft skills trainer. But we are not here to talk about me. We are here to talk about you all. How can this session benefit you all? Well, no matter what you do, no matter which field you belong to or whatever you want to learn in life, something that we all want is to continuously enhance our skills. Is to continuously improve in order to keep up with the world, isn't it? So before I begin, I want to lay some of the ground rules. By the end of the session, you will have a Q&A. So I request you all to be patient till then and listen to what I have to say so that you can gather it in and then we can have a conversation after the session. The topic, as I said, is going to be something that is going to benefit everybody here, and that is skill acquisition. What is skill acquisition? How can we acquire different skills? How can we master them and do it considerably well? Is something that we are going to discuss throughout the session. So first things first, what exactly is skill acquisition? Well, it is a type of learning, basically, which is based on a continuous process. It is a continuous learning which gives you results that you desire. It is something that you want to do. It could be as menial as making a cup of tea or learning cooking, which for me is a very big task. But it could also be something that you want to learn, like language or maybe learning programming for your career. How do you go about that? How do you, in this world where you do not have much time, how do you manage your time and see that this is something that can fit my schedule and I can acquire the skill apart from the career that I have, apart from the profession that I have? Well, with enough repetition and the performance, this eventually becomes automatic. And this is something that is, I am sure everybody wants. Moving forward, I'm going to discuss a very, very interesting stage, a very interesting model that is considered for skill acquisition, and we call it the conscious competence model. Now, leaving the technicalities behind, let's jot it down certain terms here. Now, unconscious incompetence is something that we start with. Let me break it down a little more for you. Suppose you want to learn how to drive, okay? But in the earlier stages of our life, we didn't know that this is a task that we want to do, or maybe we want to learn. That is what we call unconscious incompetence. That means that this is something that you don't know that you want to learn, isn't it? Now, unconscious incompetence is the first stage in this model in which you didn't know that you wanted to learn a skill. Also, we didn't know much about the skill. We didn't know what we want to learn and how to go about it. But as we grew up, we discovered that this is a life skill. We discovered that this is something you have to have if you want to live a smooth life, because it is a kind of necessity for our everyday lives, isn't it? That's when you became conscious about this. And what you did, you hired a trainer, like everybody. I'm sure that it would have been a family member or a trainer that must have taught you how to drive, right? So in this stage, we have learned enough that this is the skill that we want to learn, and we hired somebody for it. And this stage can be very uncomfortable to enter, because now we are aware that we have entered it and we are going to learn this skill, but we still don't know much about that. The third is wherein you enter into a stage where you are consciously competent. Now you are learning it, you have the steering in your hand, you have to take care of all your gears. You have to take care. You have to look on the screen. You cannot distract yourself. Absolutely no provision for an error because you are trying to achieve it, right? So in this stage, we have to maybe find ourselves to be able to perform the skill increasingly well. And this is where you have to constantly be there in the situation where you are learning the skill and actually practicing it. And this is at par the most difficult and uncomfortable one. But believe you me, the high that you feel, the amazing experience that you have here is something that you will never forget and is actually going to take you to the fourth step, which we call unconscious incompetence, which means you are unconsciously competent about a certain skill. Your unconscious competence is a stage where your ability to perform the skill has become almost second nature, which means that you can drive your car and maybe play music at the same time, talk to your friend, or maybe use a mobile. But I do not suggest it whatsoever. That is very risky, but it's just an example to put forward. Okay, now each one of us can probably identify multiple domains in which we are, you know, these stages can be established. Being in the conscious stage can be a bit, dicey, but it also provides you an opportunity to improve your learning. And that tells you that you can master any skill. So these four stages are something that are applicable universally. And you can absolutely apply it no matter what field you belong to, right? Moving forward, we have certain steps to develop a skill. Those were the stages. Now let's move forward and see what are the kind of steps that are involved, where to begin with. Building knowledge is the foremost step that we need to consider. Now, what is building knowledge? It is to make yourself aware of the subject that you want to learn. Gather all the knowledge that you have, build your conscious in a way that, okay, this is something I want to learn. And this is something that I want to be here. That is what we call defining your goal before you even begin. So that at the end, you can retaliate with whatever you decided and wherever you have reached, right? So building the knowledge is entirely about building your conscious to be able to reach where you want to. Second is recording yourself. Now, by that, suppose you want to learn maybe public speaking. That is something we all fear, right? So public speaking, or maybe you want to eliminate your stage fright. Where to begin with? Now you have to gather all the information. By gathering all the information, I mean building the knowledge, which was the first step. Second is recording your knowledge, where you can maybe express yourself and review yourself. For a public speaker to become a speaker, you maybe can record yourself in a camera by looking in the camera or talking to the mirror. Or if you want to develop a habit of reading, that is also a challenge for a lot of people. You can maintain a reading journal wherein you can review whatever you have learned. You can write down. That is something we call recording your knowledge. Then comes expressing it. Now, to express your knowledge, what I mean is to actually practice it, right? Before practicing, the stage of expressing is very, very important because this is where you will actually perform a certain task. Then you need to expand your horizons. Then you need to expand your domains and see whatever there is that you can do that can add on to your skill set. This will help you to become the master of whatever field you are in. Last, but I would say by far the most important one, is practicing the knowledge. Now, this is where the real juggle comes in. This is where the hassle lies. And this is what we can learn by practicing something that Malcolm Gladwell coined. This is a term which is known as a 10,000 hour rule. Suppose there is a skill in which you want to become a master of. You want to be proficient in a certain skill where you can absolutely take absolutely no mistakes and you want to be perfect in that. So Outliers is a book which is written by Malcolm Gladwell, who is 5 times a New York Times bestseller author. He writes about self-development, he writes about business. So I am not telling you this, he is somebody who has coined this in a book which is known as Outliers, which is also his bestseller. Now this 10,000 hour rule tells us a model, which is very interesting. Now what does it tell us? That You have to continuously practice a certain skill if you want to become a master in it. Suppose you want to, as I said, learn programming if you are into CS or computer sciences. So what you do is you begin and then you continuously keep on practicing for 10,000 hours to achieve the proficient level, which means you want to master a certain skill, right? You want to be the best in the industry. What does this 10,000 hours mean? Is you have to master your craft, right? So it means 8 hours a day for 5 days a week. If you're doing it, it will go on to 44 weeks a year and 5.5 years. I mean, do we actually have that kind of time in this fast-paced world wherein we are trying to constantly keep up with the world? That is exactly why we started to learn a skill. So not all of us want to become proficient and best in everything we want to do, right? You can be best in one thing and the other things you just want to do it. So this means that this 10,000 hour rule is considerably challenging, right? For maybe a lot of us, right? Majority of people don't have that kind of time in this kind of scenarios. So what do we do now? Now, here comes who we call the master of skill acquisition, who is Josh Kaufman. Now, Josh Kaufman is known as the father of skill acquisition for a reason. And the reason is that he dismissed this 10,000 hour rule. He said that this is the world wherein everybody is running. Everybody wants to develop a skill, constantly improve themselves, but they want to continuously keep up with the pace also. So what he did was he wrote a book, which was The First 20 Hours. It is named as The First 20 Hours, in which he wrote about the 20-hour rule. Yeah, right. So from 10,000 hours, you come to 20 hours, just and only 20 hours. So Josh Kaufman told that if you want to master a skill, if you want to go from knowing absolutely nothing to doing it considerably well, you need to devote just 20 hours, which means 40 minutes a day for a month. Now, this is something that almost everybody can adapt. This is something which is tried and tested in the field. It is not something that has been coined theoretically or something that is not at all possible. No, that's not the case here. He did this, he wrote this book just because he wanted to offer a systematic approach to a rapid skill acquisition so as to how to learn a new skill as quickly as possible. Now, his method shows us how to deconstruct complex skills and maximize the productivity practice. Now, by completing just 20 hours of focus and deliberate practice. Now, this is somewhere you cannot break your consistency and you will have to absolutely be, distraction-free, in a distraction-free mode so that you are continuously there. As I said, this method is not theoretical, it's field-tested. And, Kaufman even invites the readers to join him in this approach and he challenges everyone that, okay, you practice this, you deliberately do this, religiously do this for about a month and then you tell me that are you able to do it considerably well or not. So as I said, it is completely tested method in which he tells that first you need to deconstruct the skill, which means that pick up a new skill and it could be anything, maybe related to your field or maybe a hobby. Pick up that skill that you want to learn. Enhance your skill by continuously self-correcting. Now you are in a self-taught mode right now, right? You want to learn something. Also, you want to learn something very, very rapidly. Rapidly, I mean that you do not have much of a time, as I said, 10,000 hours. So you need to remove all the barriers of the learning, which means that anything that stands in your way that is breaking your consistency is not worth it. So make sure that you are consistent for about a month. There are no Sundays, absolutely nothing whatsoever. And believe you me that this absolutely works. Now, both these models, whether it is the 10,000 hour rule or a 20 hour rule, tells us that intensity doesn't matter, consistency does. For example, there is a man who is trying so hard to lose weight, right? And he starts with all his vigor and vitality. And what he does is he exercised for 2 hours long, okay? But for the next entire week, he is lost. He couldn't keep up with the pace because he didn't have 2 hours to devote to. Now, you tell me, is he really going to lose his weight? Absolutely not. If you're doing an exercise for about 2 hours, but it's only for a day, in a month or in a week, that is not going to take you anywhere. But there's another man who is religiously going to maybe walk or running for 20 minutes or 30 minutes a day, but he's doing it consistently for about 5-6 days a week. Yes, he is going to lose weight, which tells us that consistency does matter more than intensity. So whenever you start, make sure that you have all the motivation, but that doesn't mean that you will back out after a day or two, because that is exactly when most people fail. And we all know that life is all about growth. Either you grow or you die, because if you're not growing, it means you're dead. So with this thought, I want to end my session here. But before I do, I would love to hear all your questions, anything that you want to ask me. We can share our thoughts and learn from each other. All your questions are welcome.
Vicky, are you there?
Yeah.
Any questions from her?
I want to ask one question. Yes. Yes. Actually, great, but I really want to appreciate the example. And I really want to ask one thing from you. That, I want to ask one thing from you that I always try to maintain consistency in my every task, but there are certain factors that impact you a lot. So just tell me one thing, that how you deal with this thing, how the tip you want to give us to deal with the external or internal factor or something like this, if you can give to us.
Definitely. Okay, now whenever we set a certain kind of, you know, habit tracker for ourselves, suppose you're maintaining a journal or you have a habit of, you know, maybe writing it in a piece of paper, right? Okay. You're tracking your progress. That's something that keeps you motivated from within. No, I want to take it for today also. I want to do it for one more day and then I'll be consistent for 3 months. That is how you deal with your inner turmoil. But when it comes to the outer world's distraction and something that is going to distract you and you are not able to keep up with your schedule, how do you deal with that? Is exactly what I said. You have to be in a distraction-free mode, which means that anything that hampers your growth, I think, should not be in our life. Anything that you think is distracting you from your self-development, I think it's not worth it. So maintain a habit tracker. That really, really helps. It tells you your progress, and that is exactly what I meant when I said review your performance. So when you're reviewing your performance, you're actually teaching yourself. You're your own teacher. And that is the best possible way to learn anything.
Okay, great. Thank you so much for this. And sometimes the person is not emotionally well to have the consistent performance.
That's so, okay. You need not to be so hard on yourself. Nobody's giving you marks here. This is not an exam. You will pass it. This is life. Everybody is going to excel here, because we might have different journey. We might have different goals. So set a goal that is practical. Set a goal that is achievable. That is very important.
The smart goal should be there.
Yes, everybody has different goals. So if you are setting a goal with the perspective of somebody else, you know, he is doing something, he is working out for an hour and I will have to do it for an hour itself. That is not possible. You ask yourself, how much is your capability? How much you can do for yourself? And even if it's for 20 minutes, that doesn't matter. That's your goal.
Definitely. I'm just asking question on behalf of everyone. Sometimes I always get to know that they are feeling like this, that's why they're not working, they're not consistent, they're not feeling okay from outside. So I just wanted to know the things, the tips that you shared. I really want to appreciate it. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much. And it's always good to ask questions.
Yeah, I'm really happy to have this session, and I really want to appreciate one example that you told to us about the loss weight. And I really, the consistency is very much important as compared to intensity.
Definitely, definitely.
Yeah, I am really happy to have this session.
Thank you. I'm so glad you liked it.
Yeah, I really liked it. Captain Shekhar, now it's all over to you.
Any more questions? Archana, any question? Naina, Pooja?
No, sir.
You have very good opportunity to speak this special guest speaker. So don't leave this opportunity. If you have any questions related to the topic, or even little irrelevant also, you can ask her. No questions from anyone? Ansi, are you there?
Yes, sir.
Can we proceed with the vote of thanks now?
Sure, sir. We would like to propose a hearty vote of thanks to Jasmine Kaur for gracing today's webinar and delivering the important topic on skill acquisition, Let's Learn How to Learn. I am sure that all the participants have taken note of your suggestion and will initiate that further in their career. Lastly, we thank you again on the behalf of the whole Aircruise Aviation Private Limited team. It was an amazing session, ma'am. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much. You have been a love.